Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So here we have taken another sum on freehand drawing. Here we'll be drawing nuts. So first we'll draw hexagonal nut. So as in the question, D we have to assume. I have assumed D as 20 millimeter. You can assume it 30, 40, anything. As we have assumed D as 20 millimeter, the height we are also considering 20. That is capital T is 20. Below that I am marking a light line. Now I am marking the center point of this, and 2D will be 40 millimeter as D we have considered 20. So from the center, 20 on right and 20 on left. So the bottom line is 40 millimeter as given in the question. Now I'll mark the center point as we want to draw the curve. So I'll draw a center line, light. Now we have to take the compass and draw a curve. So keep it a point anywhere on the line. Take the radius as this height and draw the curve. Now join this straight lines. Extend these lines. Same, mark a center point, draw a light line below, and with same radius, first plot the points, and with same radius you can draw the curve. Do it on the other side as well. Now you can see you have an angle of 30 degree on top. So I'll just mark the lines. Take the protractor, keep it at the edge, mark the 30 degree angle, and from the edge draw a dark line, as you can see. Also from here, 30 degrees here, mark a dark line. Now just dark the edges. The upper part is done. Just mark the dimension. This is D, which we have assumed 20 millimeter. Make this part dark. This distance is 2D. So as we have assumed 20, this will be 40 millimeter. This angle is 30 degree. This height is T. We have assumed this also 20. Now this front view is done. This is front view of hexagonal nut. Now to draw the top view, we'll take the projections downward from each and every point. Center point. Now here will be the circle tip, so this is the circle edge. We'll see how to draw it. Where the curve ends at the top, we have taken the projection that also. Now on compass, keeping the pointer here, taking this as the circle radius, keep anywhere the center point and draw the circle. After drawing the circle, this is the inner circle. We have taken the projections, so you can directly draw the circle. The inner edge circle, one whole circle and one half circle. You can draw the whole circle as well there. Now you have to draw a hexagon at the edges. So as given in the question, first I'll mark the center line. From here I'll draw a dark line. This is 20. From here drawing a tangent to the circle, you have to draw. So the pointers, just look how I'm drawing. I'm drawing a perpendicular and tangent to the circle from all the edges, and this we have drawn a hexagon. This distance is W. Now we have done with the top view. Now moving towards the side view. For side view, I'll take the projections from the front view to the side view. So height has been taken from the front view, and the depth, that is the height of W, will be taken from the top view. So height of W, we'll see it is around 3.5. So here I'll mark a distance of 3.5, extend it upwards. Now the center point, we'll mark the center point here also. I will take on compass. First we'll mark the center line, and same as we have done in the front view, the same height with a distance, we'll do it on the side view as well. So these are the curve. From the side view, it will be same as the front view. Extend this, make this part dark as given in the question. From the center line, 1 millimeter to the left, 1 millimeter to the right. These are the edges of the nut. This will be W as we have projected from the top view. And we are done with the hexagonal nut. Next we'll draw square nut. This square nut will start drawing with the top view. So first I'll draw axis line for the top view. Then from the center, I'll mark 20 millimeters on the left, 20 millimeters on the right, 20 millimeters on the top, and 20 millimeters on the bottom. As you want to create a diagonal square, then I'll join these lines and we'll create a square. So I have not assumed anything, I have directly drawn the square. Then from the center, with this as a radius, I'll draw the circle as seen in the question. After drawing the circle, I'll draw the, extend these lines upward to the front view. Draw the center circle D. And little bit increase and draw the outer edge of the nut. Make this distance dark. I'm marking a point about 20 millimeter. Note, this is not the point T, this is the side edge. Then from here, 30 degree angle as given in the question. Extend the part a bit dark. From here also 30 degree angle. Extend the part a bit dark. Now this distance I'm marking, this is T. Extend a line. Now same 30 degree angle will mark, or you can directly mark a point here and then join this. Given in the question, do the lines. This is the square nut edges. This angle is 30 degree. This distance is T. This is D. We have not assumed any distance, we have directly drawn. This is W. We are done with the step 1 part. Now step 2, where the square nut is straight square, I'll get this distance only and draw the square here with same sides. It is around 2.8. We have drawn the square. I will extend this upward to the front view. We have to mark the center point also. So for center point, what you can do directly, just join the diagonals and you will get the center point. So this is the center. From that center, we'll draw a circle. Then we'll draw the D, the nut, the outer edge. This is D. This is W. Now on top, we'll take the dimensions from here only. Make this dark, take the center point, take the radius, take any distance, it should be on the top, draw the curve. So this is R. Mark the edges. And we are done with the square nut. Next we'll draw wing nut. As you can see, it has many dimensions. So I'll assume first D is equal to 20. So 2D will be 40. Then 1.5D will be 30. 1.2D will be 24 millimeter. 0.6D will be 12. 0.4D will be 8. 0.2D will be 4. So as I have assumed D is equal to 20, these are the dimensions. Now first I'll mark the length, that is 2D, that is 40 millimeter. We'll start with that. Then I'll draw a line above, that is D, at a distance of D, that is 20 millimeter above. Then we'll draw a light line. As you can see in the question. Then I'll mark the center point, that is 20. We'll draw a straight perpendicular line up, crossing the above line, and from that center point we will draw 1.5D, so that will be 30. So from the center, 15 millimeters on both the sides. Then we'll join this line, and this part is done. Now next, 1.2D will mark, that is 24 millimeter. So from the center, 12 millimeters on both the sides, which gives us 24 millimeter. Now from here, 8 millimeter above, that is 0.4D, will mark a point and will draw a line. Light line will draw. This will be the line where the center of the semicircle will be drawn, that is 0.6D. Now next, for drawing the semicircle on compass, we'll take the radius as 0.6D, that will be 12 millimeter. Before that, we'll mark the point. We'll take this as reference line. From this point, we'll draw a line above. From this point, we'll draw a line above. That will be the start point of the semicircle. So keeping it here, I'll mark the center point. Through that center point, I'll draw the semicircle. Same on the other side. This will be the end point of the semicircle. Keeping the pointer here, mark the center point, and keeping the pointer at the center, drawing the semicircle. After the semicircle is drawn, we'll join this line as shown in the question. Join this dark, join this part dark. The semicircle is bit extended downward, so I'll just increase the semicircle so it looks a smooth curve. Now after this, bottom I'll draw the circle with diameter D. So D is 20, so I'm taking radius as 10 millimeter. So 10 millimeter, keeping the pointer here and drawing the circle. So this is the circle with diameter D. which is 20 millimeter, bit increase and then draw the another circle. Now taking its projections upward, the dotted line, so this will be the front view. This part is hidden, so it is dotted. Draw the center axis line. Now the wing thickness is 0.2D, that is 4 millimeter. So from the center, 2 millimeter above and 2 millimeter below, I'll mark the lines. So this distance is 4 millimeter. From here also, 2 mm above and 2 mm below. So this will be the end point. This will be the end point. And the starting point is this, which I have highlighted. So taking the projection downward, and we have got this point. Now completing this wing from the top view, it will look like a rectangle shape. Now taking this as the radius, keeping it at this center, drawing the circle. So from the top, it will look like a circle. Then taking this as the radius till this point, keeping at the center, drawing the another circle. So this is the top view of the wing nut. Just marking the dimensions. Whatever dimensions are given in the question, just mark them. And we are done with the wing nut. Next is capstan nut. So here the dimensions are, D will assume as 20 millimeter. According to that, 0.2D will be 4, 0.5D will be 10 millimeter, and 1.8D will be 36. So we'll start with drawing a square of width 1.8D, that is 36. So this is 36 and height is D, that is 20 millimeter. So we'll draw a square of that. Mark the center point. So 36 center point will be 18. Through that we'll draw a straight perpendicular line. This is the center point. We'll draw a straight light line. Now we'll draw with the top view. So the circle, this will be the radius. And according to that, keeping the pointer, we'll draw a circle. This is the top view. Now we'll mark the center point of the square. We'll draw a center line, and we have to draw a small circle of diameter 4, so radius is 2. So I'll just drawing it by hand, as 2 millimeter radius is very small to draw using compass, so you can draw it freehand. This on the both sides, as it is 3-dimensional, it will look like an ellipse shape. So I've drawn like this. Then the edges of the capstan nut, the top part, this dotted lines, these are the behind circles. Now taking this as the radius, draw the circle. Then take this as the radius, draw another circle, draw it half or you can draw it full also. As given in the question I have drawn, marking the center line. Now you have to draw this holes. The distance is 0.2D, so 4 millimeter, so 2 millimeter on both the sides. The height will be also 4 millimeter, and join. Then draw a triangle at the tip and make it dark. Same like this, with a width of 4 millimeter, make a triangle at the top, make it dark. Diagonally also do it like this. Mark the center point. From the center point, left side 2 millimeter, right side 2 millimeter. Mark the points. Do it on both the sides with a height of 4 millimeter. Make a triangle at the tip. Then last two, mark the center point, left side 2 millimeter, right side 2 millimeter. You have to divide this whole circle into 6 equal parts and you have to do this. Height is 4 millimeter and the width is also 4 millimeter as given in the question. And with this, we are done with the top view. Just marking off the dimensions. We are done with capstan nut. Next, we'll learn to draw curling nut. Here I have assumed D as 40 millimeter, so 0.1D will be 4 millimeter, 0.8D will be 32 millimeter, and 1.8D will be 72 millimeter. So it's not given in the question, but the width of this curling nut is 72 millimeter. So we'll create a rectangle of width of 72 millimeter and height of 0.8D, that is 32 millimeter. Make this square a bit light, as at the edges we have to draw an angle of 45 degree. Now to draw an angle of 45 degree, it's just a shortcut. The width is 0.1D, that is 4 millimeter, so we'll mark 4 millimeter distance from the edges. As you can see, 4 millimeter on the top and on the left right side as well. So from the edges 4 millimeter apart, I'm marking points, and after joining these points we'll automatically get an angle of 45 degree. So no need to take the protractor and draw the angle. Now join these lines and make it dark. So the upper part is done, outer rectangle is done. Now I'll mark the center point of 72 is 36, and from there I'll draw a light line, that will be the center line. Top view will take this as the radius. From here I'll draw a circle, and then keeping the center and taking this till the end as the radius, drawing the outer circle. Now we have to mark the inner grooves. So 20 millimeters on the left and 20 millimeters on the right. That will be D. So left side it is hidden and right side we are drawing a straight line. So this distance is D, that is 40 millimeter. So we have marked 20 millimeter on both the sides. Now from the center, that is 0.8D. So 16 on the left and 16 on the right, so total is 32 millimeters, that is 0.8D. so again left side hidden, right side dark. Now with this as the radius, we'll draw the outer circle. This is D, that is the diameter of 40, and with this as the inner circle. So the top view is done. This part is D. Just mark it. Now the knurling has this sectional lines on one side. So I'll draw these sectional lines. And have hash lines on the other side. So it has a grip type of hash lines, so I'll make this part dark as knurling nut has a grip. After this, just dimensioning is remaining. This is 0.1D, this is 0.1D, that is 4 millimeters. This angle is 45 degree. And we are done with the knurling nut. Next and final nut is the ring nut. Dimensions D we have assumed 20. 0.1D will be 2 millimeter, 1.5D will be 30 millimeter, 1.8D will be 36 millimeter, 0.5D will be 10 millimeter, 0.2D will be 4 millimeter. So according to these dimensions, now we'll start with the ring nut. First we'll draw a square of width of 1.5D, that is 30 millimeter width, and height is 0.5D, that is 10 millimeter. So this height is of 10 millimeter. After drawing this square, now we'll mark the center point, mark the center line. Now from the top it is 0.1D, so 2 millimeters from the top and 2 millimeters from the bottom. On both the sides we have an extension. So from center 18 millimeters on both the sides. So from center I'm marking 18 millimeter here and 18 millimeter, which gives me 36 millimeter, that is 1.8D. Now from here I'll draw a parallel line, dark parallel line from both the sides. As you can see in the question, we'll extend this line. The center with the space of again 2 millimeters on both the side, so center part is 4 millimeter. Join this. Now we'll mark D, that is from the center 10 millimeters on the left, 10 millimeters on the right. So this is distance D. We'll mark the dotted line. This part is D. This is the another inner circle. Mark the dimensions. This is 1.5D. This outer is 1.8D. This distance is 0.1D. Now moving towards the top view, we'll take this as radius. See till where I'm taking the radius. Draw the circle. Now as you can see, the ring nut has the grooves of the outer circle. So first we'll divide the circle into 6 equal parts. So this has been divided into 6 equal parts. Now this distance The width is 0.2D, that is 4 millimeter, as I have earlier told. First we'll draw this outer circle, we'll draw this lightly. Now this width is 4 millimeter, so I'm marking this dark. Earlier we have left the 4 millimeter space in between. Now from here also 2 millimeters on the left, 2 millimeters on the right will give me the space of 4 millimeters. From here also 2 millimeters on the left and 2 millimeters on the right will give me the space of 4 millimeters, as the gap is 0.2D. I'll make the remaining circle dark. Now this part is done. This distance, as you know, this is 4 millimeter, that is 0.2D. So this gap, as I have already told, this is 4 millimeter. This is the projection from this part. Marking the remaining dimension. This is 0.5D. And we are done with the ring nut.